Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. Assalamu alaikum, everybody. This is AbdelRahman, and we're moving on, inshallah, today to the second benefit of trials that Imam Izzuddin ibn Abdus Salam, may Allah's mercy be upon him, gives us in his text. The second treasure that he presents to us is another station of ma'rifah. He says that the first station was coming to know Allah, Allah's nobility, His honor, His uniqueness in His lordship, and how the same Allah who is the Lord of everything and takes care of everything also takes care of us. And this trial that we're put in sometimes has to remind us of this, because sometimes we forget. He says the second thing that we are reminded of, there's another station of ma'rif that we come to, and he says it's dhillatil ubudiyya wa kasriha. He says that the person comes to know the station of what it truly means to be a servant and how absolutely in need of Allah they are. You know, how absolutely in need of Allah a person is. And he says, وَإِلَيْهِ الْإِشَارَةُ بِقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. He quotes the ayah from Surah Al-Baqarah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the person, and Allah here is talking about the believers, and we'll get into the passage in a little bit. He says that the person, when they are afflicted with a calamity, he says that they call out and they say that verily we belong to Allah, and to Him we are, every day we are returning to Him, and we are eventually going to return to Him in the future. So what he's saying here is, this is very beautiful, is he says that the person, Allah Ta'ala tells us in the Quran that when a person is hit with a trial, that this is one of the prescribed statements that we are told to say. That إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ, that when a person is hit with a trial, قَالُوا, they say, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ, that the person should call out and say, as a reminder to themselves. Normally we are familiar with this statement only being associated with when somebody passes away, which nevertheless is a great trial. But we also should be comfortable saying this statement when there's something that is afflicting us, something that is testing us. And there's two reasons why. Number one is that, you know, you're remembering that this life is temporary, right? إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Whatever difficulty you're going through, whatever affliction is happening to you, whatever situation you find yourself in, this statement is a reminder to you that وَإِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ, we're always going back to Allah. So I'm not going to become so broken, you know, absolutely broken to the point of complete and total dysfunction, and I'm going to lose my spirituality over something that's temporary. You know, it's like going on vacation and the hotel that you have, and you're only there for a few days, and the hotel that you have doesn't have a coffee machine that you like. Are you going to lose out on the entire vacation just because this one thing? No, you're going to enjoy what you can and then you're going to go back home. And what do you tell yourself? If there's something that you don't like in the hotel, you just say, what? I'm going to go back home eventually. Like, I'll have it back home eventually. I'm not here forever. So this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in the Quran. Number one is that it's a reminder to us that this life is temporary. And as you know, blunt as that can sound, sometimes for me personally, it's one of the only prescriptions that really gets me through things. You know, when I'm really overwhelmed, when I'm really stressed out and I don't know how to process and interpret something that's happening in my life, I just have to take a few deep breaths, sit down and tell myself, at the end of the day, this is not my home. At the end of the day, paradise is where I want to be. Paradise is where I want to go. And if I want to stay here, then this will bother me a lot. But I have to realize that this is not my home. I'm going to work hard. I'm going to enjoy. I'm going to worship. I'm going to take care of my family. But at the end of the day, everybody has to go back to Allah. So that's the first lesson. The second lesson, he says, is that in this statement, the phrase "Inna Lillahi," that we are for Allah, right? That we belong to Allah, is a reminder to yourself that you are not an independent entity. You are not existing independently. And subhanAllah, trials happen as a prescription to pull us back to Allah when we stray too far away. What do I mean by stray too far away? I mean that it is natural for us to develop a sense of independence. When things are going well, and when things are just, everything's going your way, there tends to happen inside of a human being this sense of, you know, autonomy and authority and agency that develops, that I am the reason that this happened. Right? I'm the reason that this happened. I'm the reason why I got married. I'm the reason why my business is successful. I'm the reason why I got this job. I'm the reason why we have children. You know, there's all these I moments. And then, you know, we're cruising along and everything is going well. And then suddenly things start to slow down and even stop. And we start to hit obstacle after obstacle after obstacle. And we remember that no matter how hard I try, that same person who was so convinced that it was me who was doing everything, no matter how hard I try, I'm trying hard right now and I can't get it done. And these are things sometimes that are not even that difficult, but I just can't do it. And so then at that moment is when I open my hands to Allah and I start to ask. And in those moments, you are reminded and I'm reminded that I'm not alone. I'm not the one that is in charge. I'm not the one that's doing this. You know, my dad, he used to tell me this. I'll never forget my dad. My dad lost his job when I was in high school. He used to be at a very high status in Motorola. And he got laid off. You know, it was heading into the recession. It was after 9/11. And he got laid off. And I remember one of the most powerful lessons that he taught me. May Allah bless my dad. He said, "AbdelRahman, I want to tell you something. This whole experience has taught me that you're not in control, that I'm not in control." You know, he'd been doing his job. He had been climbing the corporate ladder. He had been succeeding. He had been doing well. And he reached a very high status, an executive level status at his company. And they let him go, right? They let him go. And he told me that, you know, for all the logical, rational proofs, this was not supposed to happen. I wasn't supposed to be let go. But a team of people that were not supposed to be let go got let go. Why? Because they weren't in control. And we can figure out any other reason we want to, like, oh, maybe it's this, maybe it's that. Ultimately, the end wisdom behind it is that I'm not in control. And so Imam Ibn Abd al-Salam, he says that this is one of the fruits of these trials, is that you're straying away from Allah and now you have to come back to Allah. You are losing proximity to Allah and now you have to come back. Because when a person strays from Allah and strays from understanding that they need Allah, that's when they start to make mistakes. That's when they start to go away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I want to read to you, the verse that he quoted is very powerful. You know, he says that Allah ta'ala, وَإِلَيْهِ الْإِشَارَةُ بِقَوْلِهِ ta'ala. He says Allah ta'ala, he directs us to this, or he points to this reality when he tells us that الَّذِينَ أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ, when he says those people, when they are afflicted by a trial. Let's read the whole passage. It's very powerful, subhanAllah, and it's very relevant, especially now given the coronavirus and everything that's happening as a result of it, whether it's health and economy and everything and uncertainty. Listen to what Allah Ta'ala says. He says, in this is chapter number 2, Surah Al-Baqarah, this is verse number 155. He says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَالنَّقْصِ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. He says, and surely, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ, we will absolutely, definitely test you. This is a promise. Allah is saying, and this is, by the way, in the beginning of the Quran, chapter 2, verse number 155. Like, if a person reads the Quran, this is maybe a few pages in, what, like maybe 15 pages in. He says, you're absolutely going to be tested. This isn't going to be a surprise. We shouldn't be surprised by this. We shouldn't be caught off guard. بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَالنَّقْصِ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. He says, by a few things. Number one, you're going to be tested with fear, خوف, uncertainty. Everyone right now is afraid. Everyone right now doesn't know. The timelines keep changing every 12 hours. Things are being shut down. People are unsure about their businesses, whether they're going to be laid off, whether their businesses are going to succeed, whether their health is okay. People are unsure who's infected, who's not. I mean, all these things. And it's causing fear. Min al-khawf. This is one of the fear. Wal-jur. And hunger. This is one of the tests Allah is going to give us. That there will be times when we're going to have plenty of provision, and there will be times when we are hungry. Right? We will have hunger. And obviously, the majority of us right now, alhamdulillah, don't feel that hunger. But that's a state of privilege, because a lot of people don't have food, right? وَنَقْسِ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ, and a deficiency, a loss in your wealth, وَالْأَنْفُسِ, right? The 401ks, the wealth, the stocks. You know, people bought Tesla and now Tesla's crashing. Like, what's happening, right? Wealth is being lost. The economy is going to suffer. This is just a reality. God promised us this. وَالْأَنْفُسِ, and lives. People's lives are going to suffer, both the quality of life, and people are going to also pass away. وَالثَّمَرَاتِ, and fruits. All right, and obviously agriculture is a more direct translation. People losing their crops, but also the fruits of everything that you do, of your labor, the fruits of everything. You're earning your provision. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Allah finishes the ayah by saying, but good news. But he's saying good news to those people who persevere patiently. those people who keep going through the storm, those people who don't wake up and say, you know what? My business is suffering. My life is suffering. I'm not going to pray today. I'm not going to remember Allah today. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ. That's when the ayah comes now. Those people who, when they are hit with affliction, when a disaster hits them, they say, we belong to Allah, and indeed, to Him we will return. أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ. That those people, God has praised them. God has sent His blessings upon them. مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ. God has sent His mercy and His blessings upon those people. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. And those people for sure are the rightly guided. So this passage teaches us something very valuable, which is that afflictions will happen. They absolutely will test us. And it's up to us to respond positively in a way that shows that we are depending on Allah alone. And that is sabr. That is patience, that is perseverance, that we're going to get through this. We don't know how, but Allah Ta'ala is my Rabb. And that's why he started the book with, the person is reminded who Allah is, and now you're reminded who you are. We are nothing without Allah. We are nothing without, and that's not self-deprecating. I'm not trying to, you know, bash on everybody. It's just a factual reality. Without God, we are nothing. And so sometimes afflictions happen, and in the wisdom of those afflictions is amongst all of this, Allah giving us a test to be patient and remember Him so that we can come out of that affliction and we can tell ourselves, you know what? When Allah tested me, I didn't fail. When Allah tested me, I didn't lose. My business suffered, my life suffered, my health, whatever, I suffered. But I didn't lose Allah. I may have lost money, I may have lost health, I may have lost opportunity, vacation, plane tickets, anything. But I didn't lose Allah. We ask Allah Ta'ala to grant us the station of those who are sabireen. We ask Allah Ta'ala to make us from amongst those who are rightly guided, and that whenever we're tested with affliction, we say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Assalamu alaikum, everybody. See you tomorrow, inshallah.